Hello everyone, so in this lecture we'll see power of an element. Okay guys, so let us begin with the next topic that is important also, that is power of an element of a group. Power of an element. So we'll see one by one. So write down the definition first. Let's say D comma star, we can say that D comma star D a group, and let A belongs to G, then we can say that for any positive integer n, positive integer, we can say that, let's say n, we define, yes, a raised to power n is equals to a star a, yes, we can say that, that is n times, isn't it? Meaning is what? We can say that, that means a square means a star a. Then a cube means we can say that a star a, and that is equals to a star a square. So we can say that first perform the rightmost operation, because power is right associative, we can say that operator. So first operate, we can say that the rightmost star operation, isn't it? And so on, we can say that a power 4 will be what? A star a cube, and so on. I hope this one is clear to everyone. Now we can say that, let's say, what is a raised to power minus n? So we can say that if the algebraic structure is group, then we can define negative powers also. So negative powers are only, we can say that for group only, isn't it? So you only tell me, can we write it like that or not? A inverse raised to power n, and that is what? A inverse star a inverse star a inverse, how many number of times? We can say that n times, isn't it? So here we can say that, yes, negative and both positive powers, we can say that positive powers we can find out for any given group, isn't it? So remember, first one we can say that negative powers are defined only for the group, not for monoid. So we cannot say that, we cannot guarantee that in the case of monoid, inverse of every element will exist or not. Yes, second one we can say that, yes, let's say next one we can say that, yes, write down one note. First one you can write down, negative powers are defined only for, are defined only for, we can say that, groups, not for monoid. For some elements we can find out the inverse in case of monoid also, but we cannot say that for every element inverse will exist or not. Second one we can say that, you only tell me, yes, a raised to power m plus n will be equals to what? A power m star a raised to power n only, where m and n are what? Positive integers. Where m and n are positive integers. Isn't it? Third one, you only tell me, yes, we can say that for every element A belongs to group G, A power 0 will be what? Identity element. Identity element. So you can see in simple mathematics also, if we write, let's say 3 raised to power 4, then the meaning is what? 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. That means we can say that multiplying 3 4 times, nothing else, isn't it? Yes, we can say that 3 raised to power 4 means multiply 3 4 times, nothing else, isn't it? 3 into 3, then again 3 into 3, isn't it? Then again into 3, isn't it? Okay, so in normal mathematics, we can say that 3 raised to power 0 will be what? 1 only. Yes, so why? Why? Because here power means what? We can say that in normal mathematics, power means what? Multiplication. And we can say that for multiplication, identity element is 1. That's why here 0 raised to power 0 is what, or 3 raised to power 0 is what, 1 only. Why? Because identity element in case of multiplication is 1. That's why, yes, we can say that power of a element will be what? Identity element. Isn't it? So here 1 is identity element for, yes, multiplication. I hope this one is clear to everyone. Okay. Now let us take some examples, or we can see. Let us take one example, for instance, and we'll see how to find the powers of different elements and different powers. So let us consider one example. Let's say that is well known example. Let's say A, B, C, D. So we can say that this one is also A, B, C, D. Let's say Cayley table is given to you for any group. And let's say these are the elements A, B, C, D, B, C, D, A, then C, D, A, B, and last one is what, D, A, B, C. You know very well that this one is what, standard example of abelian group. All properties of abelian group will be satisfied. You can check. I already discussed to this example also. Now here we can find out, let's say here identity element is what, we can say that here identity element is what, A. Also we can say that, yes, what will be the A square? A square means A star A, that is A only, isn't it? That means we can say that, yes, any identity element is E, then we can say that E star E will be what, E only. Similarly, E star E, that will be also E only, identity element. Because here E star E will be E, and again E star E will be E only. So we can say that we can raise any power of identity element, always output will be what? We can say that same element, that is identity element. Next one, you only tell me what is B power 1, that is B only. Then what is B square? B square is B star B, we can say that is C. Then what is B cube? B cube can be written like that, B star B square. That means B star C, and B star C is what, D only. Similarly, what is B power 4? We can say that B power 4 will be B star B cube. So this one, this is going to be B star D, and B star D is what, A only. Isn't it? So in this manner, we can find out the powers of any element. Similarly, let's say what is C cube? C cube means we can say that C star C. Now this C star C will be what? We can say that C star C, from the table we can see that is A only. And C star A will be what? You only tell me C star A, that is C only. Isn't it? In this manner, we can find out the, we can say that power of any element. So that is the given Cayley table represents a group. So we can find out the negative powers also, because inverse will exist here. So let us take, next one. Let's say what is D raised to power 2? D square will be what? We can say that D square will be what? D star D, and D star D is C. Yes, we can see C, isn't it? Similarly, you only tell me what will be the D raised to power 0, that is identity element. And here for the group, identity element is what? A only. So for any element, if we raise the power at 0, then the resultant element or output will be what? Identity element. Similarly, you only tell me here only, let's say what is the inverse of A? Inverse of A will be A only. I already told you guys that the inverse of identity element will be what? Same identity element. Why? Because we can say that A star A inverse will be what? A only. So we can say that here, identity element inverse for the identity element is the same element. So here we can say that identity element of, or we can say that inverse of A is what? A only, because A star A is A only. I hope this one is clear to you. Okay. Next one, you only tell me what is the inverse of B. So from here we can observe inverse of B is D. So inverse of D will be what? B. And inverse of C will be what? C only. You can check, isn't it? And you only tell me if this is the question. Let's say what is the B raised to power minus 4. So we can say that B raised to power 4 means what? B inverse raised to power 4. That means we can say that B inverse star, that will be the answer. So you only tell me what is B inverse. inverse is what? D. So here we can write down that is D star D, because inverse of B is D. Now you only tell me what is D star D, that is C. So here we can write down C. Now what will be the D star C? D star C will be what? We can say that D star C will be B. And finally D star B, D star will be what? A only. So A will be the correct answer. I hope this one is clear to everyone. Isn't it? That is the meaning of, we can say that, power of an element. So for, we can say that any element, if a given group is there, so for any element we can find out the positive as well as negative. Yes, integral powers, nothing else. I hope this one is clear to everyone. Okay, so write down next example. Let us consider next one. Let's say example two, let's say addition. This is one algebraic structure. So you know very well that this one is what? Yes, abelian group or not? Yes, that is abelian group. We already checked or not? Yes, that is abelian group. So if it is abelian group, so we can find out, yes, any powers, negative or both positive, no problem at all. So if it is given that, what will be the 1 cube? So 1 cube will be what? 1 binary operation with 1 binary operation with 1, that is 3. Similarly, what is the 2 cube? 2 cube means 2 plus 2 plus 2, that is 6 only. And if it is asked that what is 2, yes, raised to power minus 3, that can be written like that, 2 inverse raised to power 3. So that is what? We can say that 2 inverse plus 2 inverse plus 2 inverse. So in this abelian group, you can say that, yes, what is the inverse of 2? Inverse of 2 is what? Minus 2. Because 2 plus minus 2 equals to what? 0. That is the identity element. Yes or no? I hope this one is clear to everyone. So inverse of 2 is what? Minus 2. So minus 2 plus minus 2 plus minus 2. So we can say that answer will be what? 6 only. I hope this one is clear to everyone. Okay. Write down next one. Let's say example number 3. Let us take next example. Example number 3. Yes. So let us consider one algebraic structure is given to you. R plus set of positive real numbers on multiplication. So here 1 cube. First of all, tell me what will be the identity element for multiplication. That is 1. So 1 cube will be what? 1 into 1 into 1, that is 1 only. What is the 2 cube? We can say that is 2 into 2 into 2. So that is 8 only. Now tell me what will be the 2 raised to power minus 3, that it can be written like that or not? 2 inverse raised to power 3. And that is 2 inverse into 2 inverse into 2 inverse. And inverse of 2 is what? 1 by 2. In this particular group, we can say that inverse of 2 is 1 by 2. So answer will be what? 1 by 8 and so on. Similarly, what will be the 4 raised to power 0? That is identity element. That is 1 here. So we can say that will be the correct answer. Isn't it? In the last question, if we see here, if it is given that what will be the power of 3 raised to power 0? That is identity element. And here, in case of this given group, identity element is what? 0. For addition, identity element is 0. I hope this one is clear to everyone. In this manner, you can find out the power of any element inside a group. Isn't it? I hope this one is clear to everyone. Okay, guys. So, thank you so much. So, in the next lecture, we'll see what is the meaning of order of an element of a group. We've seen what is the order of a group. Now in the next lecture, we'll see what is the order of an element of a group, isn't it? How that is defined and various properties, we can say that related properties will be also important, isn't it? So we will be discussing order of an element of a group in the next lecture. This one, power of an element of a group, is, I hope this one is clear to everyone. Okay, guys, thank you so much.